Fans of the Canadian rock band Arcade Fire might be feeling a bit of culture shock. It became one of the world's most successful indie bands with big rumbling anthems like Wake Up. But listen to Arcade Fire's new album, Reflector, and you hear more of a dance vibe.
This new album explores the Haitian roots of the band member Régine Chassagne. She and her husband, the frontman Wynn Butler, have worked with Haitian relief groups for years, and the band has donated more than $1 million to charities there.
Chassagne and Butler spoke recently to our David Green. Their new album, they said, was sparked by a trip to Haiti right after the 2011 Grammys, where Arcade Fire had just won Album of the Year in a total upset.
I mean, it was a really funny scene. It was genuinely surprising. And just the audience were just like, what is going on? Like, the security guards wouldn't let Régine back into the changing room afterwards. And we're like, oh, we just won the Grammy. Can we go back to our changing room? I don't know.
They didn't know.
We're not celebrities.
Like,
they don't know
who we are.
They didn't recognize you and know that you just won the Grammy?
It's like, did you see me like 1 second earlier when I was on the stage?
So you're on this big stage, all this excitement, and then you land in Haiti. And that's the moment where you say, we've got to do something different here.
Well, we've kind of prepared to play there. And then there's people coming just from the mountains to watch us play. We've never heard the Beatles before. And
maybe never will.
You realize, stripped of that context, what you're kind of left with is rhythm and emotion and melody. And it kind of gets back to this really kind of basic, these kind of building blocks of music. And so we kind of wanted to start from there and try and make something out of it.
We should say this is not the first time that Arcade Fire has had Haitian music. I mean, you have sung about Haiti before on the first album.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's always been an undercurrent. I mean, I remember going over to Regine's aunt and uncle's place when we were first dating, and she had these really intense uncles that were all super political and had these really deep voices and would talk about Haiti and the problems in Haiti and...
Intense uncles. I love that. Everyone has an intense uncle somewhere.
Yeah, she had Uncle Albert that had the best voice, like, hello, Régine. He'd always, like, pull you aside and have, he's like, never forget what I'm about to tell you. This is the most important thing. And then he'd kind of zone out because he'd kind of ramble on.
Régine, what's it been like going back there recently? I know you and the band have spent a whole lot of time there, both before and after the earthquake, we should say.
Well, it's been... very inspiring, and I'm just very happy to be able to go there because I've always wanted to go since I was little, but we never got to because nobody wanted to go back. My mom was like really traumatized. She didn't want to go back ever, but she passed away, so then I decided to go anyway.
Some of the memories of the difficult life there were keeping her away?
She had an experience where she had to run, basically, like, she got home and a bunch of her family had been killed, and she and her sister had to, like, take refuge in it and pretty much leave immediately, just, like, grab what was ever on their backs and leave.
There's a place, a Haitian town called Jacmel, and it's actually a place that our listeners learned about because NPR did some reporting there.
It's an incredible place.
Once a very beautiful town that just took such a hit during the earthquake. What is it like now? Is it coming back?
We were there for carnival. The carnival in Jacmel happens a week before Mardi Gras. It's like the greatest carnival in the world that I've seen. No disrespect to Trinidad or Brazil or whatever. It's the most spectacular, living, breathing folk art. Like, every single person's a painter, everyone's an artist. The streets are just filled with the most spectacular costumes and music, rah-rah music in the streets and floats with compa bands.
And rah-rah music is a very famous street music in Haiti. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, rah-rah, I mean, actually the song Here Comes the Nighttime, the fast parts in that song are kind of like a rah-rah beat.
Take us to Haiti through the music here.
Well, when you go to Port-au-Prince, when it's kind of evening and the sun's going down and there's no electricity in a lot of Port-au-Prince and everyone's kind of really hustling to get home because it can be kind of dangerous in a lot of neighborhoods. And
you have to get home before nightfall. I mean,
you have to get home before nightfall. And people are like, have their bags of groceries and are like sprinting in the streets trying to get home. And then you see like three dudes like in these like really sharp suits that are like just stepping out to like go out to a nightclub or something like that. And you kind of have this duality where it's this really exciting atmosphere, but then also really dangerous at the same time.
When a lot of people think of Arcade Fire, they think of big sound, big anthems. This feels like a more fun, danceable album. I mean, do you feel like you got the change you were looking for?
Yeah, we definitely got the sound we were looking for. It's not entirely a dance record. It's just more rhythmic. And our kind of goal was if we went back to playing Haiti or in South America, that people would really dance and get into it equally as much as if we're playing in Brooklyn.
What I wanted to do is to be able to make music that I'm kind of stuck in a little bit in both worlds. So I would like something to make that basically my mom could dance to.
Mm-hmm.
So, but she wouldn't dance to a New Order song, but she would dance to the Haitian beat. Win and the dudes, they don't. You know, I want to kind of do something that everybody can lock into.
Is that what you call the rest of the band, Win and Dudes? I like that.
Win and the Dudes.
Well, thank you both so much for taking the time to chat with us. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you.
Régine Chassagne and Wynn Butler of Arcade Fire. Their new album is Reflector.
And tonight, NPR Music is streaming Arcade Fire's live performance from Capitol Studios here in Southern California. Listen at nprmusic.org. This is Morning Edition from NPR News with David Green. I'm Renee Montaigne.
And I'm Steve Inskeep.